Hi, this is Rich, and welcome to Coffee with Rich. Let's have some coffee and talk about it. Oh, yeah, too much coffee, maybe. Yeah. But yeah, what do you think about ETs, like their intelligence, their technology? What about these guys? Do you think they have the advanced technology to create reality systems or simulated realities? Or virtual realities? Do you think they have that tech? You know, when we talk about this being a matrix, well, somebody or something made it. Yeah. So, oh my gosh. Oh, I just got up. I'm talking too loud. God damn it. Oh, I get excited about this stuff. So I better talk a little quieter. Okay. I've got to talk quietly because I left the door open and somebody else is creating a video and interrupting. ETs. This idea of a matrix reality, this place, would take some advanced technology, wouldn't it? Have you noticed how in this world, the technology is getting very advanced? We've got augmented reality stuff. We got, you know, the Google lens, and we got all these different things. You can look through the lens, and you can see, you know, virtual reality stuff. We've got our virtuality masks. People are, they're working on their virtual reality touchy-feely thing, haptic gloves and haptic suits. And I heard that the Japanese or somebody's working on the smell. Oh man, that's a big one. You're walking into the forest in your virtual reality, you know, and they can kick in a pine scent, a little bit of bark and a little bit of dirt or stream, smell of it. What is it? Whoa. Well, anyway, technology, advanced technology, creating these virtual realities. If this has been done, and this is a matrix universe? Wow. How are they doing that? And how are realities created? You'd have to ask, what is a reality? What does it mean? This is real. Do you know what this is real means? Like, if I'm gonna name it, this is real, man. I'm not fucking kidding you, man. This is a real cup and this is a real coffee, man. It's real. How the fuck do I know? It's because I can touch it. I can feel it. Everything. Feel the temperature, the weight. I can perceive the distance it is from me. Heavy. The pull of the gravity and blah, blah, blah. I can go. I can hear it. It's got a certain ring to it. It's real, man. So that's one way. That's a personal reality. But some people, for whatever reason, can see things that other people can't see. Clairvoyant. Third eye open. Psychic. Paranormal abilities. They can see things that you and I can't. And they can see it crystal clear. It's not a vague shadow or something. And it's like sitting over there. It's like there's a guy sitting over there on the couch. And everybody else, all your rest of your family, you go, yeah, that's Uncle Charlie. Shut the fuck up. Everybody sees Uncle Charlie. You walk over and touch Uncle Charlie. Oh, Uncle Charlie's real. Oh, okay. I thought he was dead. No, Uncle Charlie's fine. He just came to visit, and he's asleep on the couch over there. Oh, okay. That's one thing. If you look over there and see Uncle Charlie, and then everybody else, hey, when did Uncle Charlie get here? I thought he was dead. Uncle Charlie is dead. Well, I can hear him snoring over there. They don't see what you see. Okay, Now, if it's only one person in your family that did not see Uncle Charlie on the couch over there, but you see Uncle Charlie, everybody else sees Uncle Charlie, but this one other person doesn't see Uncle Charlie, something's wrong with that other person. You're fine. Your rest of your family's fine. You all agree. You see Uncle Charlie, you go, yeah, he's really there. It's like really there. You're agreeing that he's really there, that you or the rest of the family aren't just seeing shit, okay? Then we define that as real because there's agreement that it's real. Doesn't matter if it's really real, if it really exists. It doesn't matter if it exists. It matters if there's agreement. Makes it real. So that one person in your family not seeing it, well, you're going to think something's wrong with that person. And that person is going to think something's wrong with the family. They're out reality. It's not real to me that you're, what do you mean, Uncle Charlie? So, yeah. Okay, so if you can see things that other people can't see, and you think other people can see them, you take it for granted, you assume, and you go, wow, look, that's real. So if you see like a spaceship flying around and you look up, look, it's clear as a bell, you know, it's clear as can be. It's the classic, you know, saucer-shaped spacecraft or some shit. And you go, you check, did you see that? Because you want to make sure it's real, right? Are you seeing what I'm seeing? If there's four or five people standing around you and they look up there and say, no, we're not seeing no freaking UFO, dude, get over it. And you're still looking up at it and they're not seeing it, that's going to make you feel a little funny, like, what's wrong here? There's either something wrong with them, there's something wrong with you, or there's something wrong with that. But reality is getting a little shaky. And you go, am I imagining that? So you would have to question that. If nobody else seeing or feeling or perceiving what you are, they're not agreeing with it. And you have to question your perception and go, is it real? I think it's real. I can touch it and feel it. Can you touch? And they don't know, don't see anything. They're not agreeing with you. It's not within their reality that what you're experiencing is real. So if you have an entire world telling you that what you're seeing spaceships all over the freaking place, and you can touch them, you can talk to the beings, nobody else can. You may have a very strong personal reality, and you know, screw them, I know I'm seeing it. I'm fine with that. That's okay. But a lot of people, their reality is shaken because nobody's agreeing with them, with their perception. And it's like, oh man, I must be hallucinating. And there's people like this all the time. And they tell their family, usually when they're younger and they don't really know what's going on, the children see things, hear things. The rest of the family doesn't see or hear. And they end up, the kid ends up going to the doctor, so they stop seeing that stuff. Or they stop talking about it. Because it's not real. They're told it's not real. So what this has to do with reality, generally speaking, is what you perceive becomes more real the more it's agreed upon as real. Make sense? Sure that. Okay. Now, this tells us that if you can imagine something, and somebody else can imagine and see what you imagined, like they're psychic, they're telepathic, and you think of a gold ball, ta-da, and somebody with clairvoyant can see clearly what you've imagined and visualized, and they see your mental imagery. And they agree that it's a little ball, or it's a horse, or it's a rabbit, it's a tree. That's one person. If everybody in town, if you imagined a big giant oak tree in city square where there was none, but everybody in town could see it, they may not know how it got there, but when they go touch it and feel it, and they go, wow, that's, how is this possible? This is real. Is this real? They're questioning the reality of it, but they're using their senses, their ability to perceive, touch, feel, smell, taste, hear, to determine its reality. And so now it's real. By agreement, by definition. If we all agree that it exists by virtue of the fact that we can touch it and smell it and hear it and all that, then it exists. If somebody in the group can't see it, touch it, feel it, smell it, then something's wrong here. Either that person is not in touch with reality, or everybody else is not in touch with reality, and he's the only one in touch with reality. So this idea of this ability with one's imagination to imagine an environment and then step into it and touch it is that which creates reality. But it's not real. It's not this reality, because other people can't see it, feel it, touch it, smell it, or anything. But when you find other people who can move into that reality, that imagination, that shared dream, then there's agreement that this is going on. This does exist. It may just exist for the five people who share the dream, but it's real. It's no longer just the imagination. And whether it's, you call it just imagination or you call it real, the point is that you can feel it. I mean, it feels very real, but it's not real because nobody else can see it or feel it. But to you, it's very real. Well, this is very real to me. This reality is very real to me. But fourth density reality, this other reality we hear a lot about, I'm not seeing it, I'm not touching it, I'm not feeling it. Is it real? Well, I guess, but I don't have firsthand experience of it right now. I do when I have an out-of-body experience, and I get in those non-physical realms, and I go, damn, this is real. And I'm touching it and feeling it, and, you know, my God, I'm looking at it. I'm just absolutely fascinated with it. And I look at my own hands and go, oh my God, whoa. It's just incredibly amazing what realities really are. And in fact, we create them subconsciously or consciously. So, wow. So these ETs, with their advanced understanding and their long-lived lives, understand this phenomena. And they have technology, just like here on Earth, we're working on the technology for virtual reality games and things like that. Their technology is our technology, advanced by a million years. And you're able to step into, you know, worlds like Ready Player One. And it's as if real, but you know it's not real because you agree that it is a virtual reality system. And everybody within the virtual reality system agrees that it is a virtual reality. And everybody agrees that the physical universe is the real reality. Okay. So you could say, argue, that when one imagines a realm and 10 people can tune into it like a co-created dream, that everybody in the dream world, they're wide awake. It's like an out-of-body experience for them. They could say, this is real, but it's not physical reality. Or depending on how you like to say it and your belief systems, you can say, this is not real. This is not reality. And everybody going, yeah, we know, Joe, physical universe, reality, got that. But can you touch and feel this? Yes, I can. This is just my imagination. Yes, it is. It is just your imagination. But whether you stick around or not, that's creepy. Did you hear that? It's got the fuck out of me. What's real and what's not? Is this fucking thing going, please charge. Please get the fuck out of my space, you scary fucker. What was it? So anyway, so you could have that argument whether it's real or not, but you're playing with the words. What it gets down to is your personal experience, and how clear is the audio? How crystal clear is the visuals? Can you smell it? Can you feel the breeze blowing through your hair? Can you touch the ground? Can you pick up the sand and go like this and see every little piece of sand and see it sparkle in the sunlight? Yes, in those worlds and realms you can. So that's what I wanted to say about reality and what it has to do with ETs and making contact with ETs is that this reality is kind of like a matrix. It's kind of a trap. We're stuck in these bodies. We can't get out. We don't have memory. We live a life here, and then we get a mind wipe, or we have amnesia, and we just, and we're back, and you start all over. There's no telling how many times we've started over with this mind wipe thing or this blank memory thing. Over and over and over again. So if you can have an encounter with a friendly ET or an extra dimensional higher plane being, they get this. And if they have some love and compassion in them, well, they're just there to help. How can I help you? And if you have these visual abilities, I highly recommend signing up for the ET contact event. I should tweak the label, ET or extra dimensional entity contact event, because not only are you going to be able to interact and engage with them, touch, feel, because you already have those kind of visuals because of your imagination, but will you walk away from it going, oh, I just imagined the whole thing? That's a possibility. This could happen. But what normally happens when I do this with people, they might come in thinking, oh, it's just my imagination. I do this all the time, Rich. And then I have them do a few other things they've never done before. And then I have them talk to somebody they've never talked to before. And when that other individual or that other being starts communicating back and saying shit that this person didn't imagine them to say, and then they said it, that's when it gets creepy for them. They go, and then when that other being starts telling them stuff that they didn't know, they're like, their belief system about this just being my wild and vivid imagination starts to crack a little bit, and it helps them open up to a new, deeper understanding of how realities are created and what it's like. There is a multiverse, and it is beyond their current belief system, and it expands their awareness, their ability, and you know, they have all these abilities, and they go, you know, I'm gonna you know what I'm gonna do with this, I'm gonna do a blah blah blah, and now they're off and running, they're off on their own, they don't need to do another training session with me. Usually learn enough in the first training session to get it down. And so this is what I'm offering, I'm sharing. It's over at richwest.net. There's a link down there. You can check it out. If you got these vivid visuals and you want to learn something like this, it's profound. It can change your eternity. I believe that some people, when they leave here, they're going to leave with a limited understanding and belief system, and they're going to end up reincarnating again, and they are very likely to be programmed yet more and more, depending on circumstances and who they're born in, what family they're born into. It could be really harsh or it could be really good. But this is a very harsh reality geared, designed to inhibit and limit the incredibly powerful creator beings that we are. And it will do that by beating up your and limiting your understanding of your abilities. Children, they're seeing things all the time. They have their favorite friends. They don't think about it real or not real. They see their buddy, and they're talking to their buddy. And they're the only one that can see them. They get programmed or told by parents, that's just imaginary, it's not real. And there you go. Programming begins as a child. And what will happen if you don't snap out of it is that when you die, when your physical body dies again, you will come right back again and do it again and again. So you learn these kinds of skills and abilities. When you leave here, I mean, you'll be able to do it before you physically expire. You'll be able to leave here and start exploring the multiverse, learning what it's really about, find your soul family, your loved ones, and so much more. And I haven't even talked about the galactic war that's going on multidimensional levels. I'll talk about that in another video. Okay? All right. Hey, thanks for watching. And I'm just having some coffee here talking. I've always wanted to do this way. Just, hey, let's just sit down and talk for a while. I want to hear what you have to say about this. What you got going there? Do you have these visuals? If you have these visuals, what are you doing with them? Some people really get it. I mean, a lot of you do. You know, hey, I see entities. I see these other realms. I go out of body all the time, you know. And so I'm not saying everybody with great visuals just has a second life and that's it. I get that a lot of you are doing great spiritual work or aspire to do that. And so I'd love to hear about that sort of thing. Because I am looking for people with these powerful visual abilities. There's lots of you guys out there. Artists, painters, movie makers, all kinds of visual artists, of course, have this kind of ability in ACES. And I'm not sure every one of you guys understand your great power and potential you have with that. So I wanted to share this with you. All right. All then. I'll talk to you later. And I really do want to talk loud. I do. But my door's open and somebody else is making a video. And I got to talk quiet. Comments, feedback, thoughts, anecdotes. I want to hear about it. I want to hear about your second life. Okay? All right. Talk to you later.